Designed from the ground up, the D'Addario Backline Gear Transport Pack is the ultimate solution for players on the move. With more than 8 specialized storage and transport compartments built right in, it makes getting everything to the gig painless and intuitive.
Usually I'll go to this 2011 Gibson Les Paul Custom. And the story I got is that it's either one of 100 or one of 300 whenever Gibson got rated for some stuff.
Oh.
I'm not 100% sure, but I know there's not very many of them out there with the maple neck and everything.
Is that because of the tone wood that was used to make it?
Yeah, I'm not really sure on the maple. You know, I know they did the maples back in the 70s a little bit. And then, you know, you don't see too many of them since then. So I guess in the 2011, somewhere around there, they made a couple of hundred of these. And I happened to see one, and I was like, I got to have that. It's pretty unique. Yeah. Yeah.
How'd you come to own that bad boy?
A friend of ours that we've known since we were back in a Suburban, man. We started in 2008. His name's Raymond Parrott. We call him Rain Man. But he used to fill up our Suburban with gas. Like, he used to get us show to show. He came to shows all the time. And he's like, y'all are going to be huge, you know. He loved our music. He's really, really good dude. And eventually he bought me, myself, Cody, and Cody some guitars. And this is the one he bought me, and I've had it ever since then.
Yo, that's a good buddy.
Yeah, for sure, man. For sure. And a couple of the guitars that he bought Cody and Cody actually got stolen out of the trailer at a Chili's one time. Terrible event. But, you know, he was really great, and he actually bought me a really special guitar, so I'm forever thankful for that.
Man, I've noticed, you know, Les Pauls can kind of vary between, you know, from Les Paul to Les Paul tonally quite a bit, especially considering, you know, that one's got, you know, some maple that might have, you know, been a different situation. What do you notice about this one in particular that's maybe different than the last one?
You know, the Customs, you know, they play a little different. The other one's a standard, and I'm used to standards, and, you know, everybody's hands are so different, you know. So, I don't have very huge hands, so whenever it comes to, like, ES guitars, I like the 35s and, you know, anything that's smaller down there. So the Customs get, a little bit wider and a little sharper, but it's basically the same package.
What pickups came in that, do you know?
I think it's just the normal, if you want to ask me, the, what is it, 390T humbuckers, or it's the classic humbuckers.
The stock one, yeah.
Yeah, pretty much the stock. Right, I never changed it. I just kind of kept it that way. And I only toured with it for a year or so, and I was like, man, I should probably, once I learned what I think I learned about the guitar, I kind of took it off the road and took it home. And I was like, I should probably stop banging this up against the wall all the time. Yeah. But it's meant to be played, you know. I don't believe in casing them. I think you should play them. So I played at home all the time.
Yeah. Plus, you got a nice guitar rack back there. That looks pretty safe.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Safe as it can be.
Right on. Yeah.